Today we're joining forces with Mark and Ying Wiens for a North Korean food adventure. From the edges of Hongdae to Seongbuk-dong to Gangnam and back, we're making a full triangle. It's my last full day in Seoul and the Wiens' first full day. Let's celebrate this chance union over a tasty marathon.
안녕, 친구!
Today we have special guests.
My name is Mark. Very happy to be here. Very happy to be hanging out with Mina.
Hello, I'm Ying. Nice to meet you.
We're going to explore three different restaurants and must eat Pyongyang Naengmyeon, along with other dishes like mandu and sundae. We begin at Dongmu Papsang. I've been here before but could not recognize the interior. It used to be half its size about a year ago. They expanded to the neighboring space.
We totally lucked out because we thought there was going to be a long queue. So we're like, we got to be here an hour before. We were the first ones here. And on top of that, it opened early at 11. And usually they open at 11:30.
I read about this restaurant and the chef, and he actually was a chef at one of the top restaurants in Pyongyang for many years before coming to South Korea. It's gonna be good.
The banchan arrives. Side dishes include baekkimchi and bean sprouts. We ordered the sogogi chomuchim. Think of it as a beef salad with various vegetables. Here comes the star of the show, Pyongyang Naengmyeon. Crowned with assorted toppings, you can sprinkle on mustard and vinegar to your liking. Growing up, I've tried sundae many times, but it's my first experience seeing it plated in a circle like this. Ah, what a colorful dish! Called jjaengban guksu, the noodles are surrounded by mostly raw ingredients, such as bell pepper, pear, and chrysanthemum leaves. The waitress pours a red-orange liquid into the copper pan. We also have cucumber, purple cabbage, and tomato, boiled egg, and three slices of beef as well.
On the top, that's the egg, island of noodles. Surrounded by the Red Sea. For chopsticks in Korea, we usually have it at the end of the table.
Oh.
We have to do some tug of war here.
Wow, that's like a tight bundle. That is a tight,
tight
bundle of noodles.
Now, this plate is pretty shallow.
The infinity edge is dripping. This infinity edging.
Isn't this nice? It looks like a flower.
There's a little bit of meat, but it's really mostly vegetarian. First bite.
Cheers, first bite together.
Together.
Yeah.
Oh wow. It's really, really refreshing because of the coolness, because of the vegetables. Nothing very strong in flavor. The noodles are not that chewy. Oh, when you taste like the broth on its own like that, you get the full flavor.
It's a little bit sour.
Uh-huh.
And maybe some vinegar in that as well.
Tastes a little bit like a light pickled briny juice.
We were talking about how like we should make a beverage out of it. I would drink it.
I would drink it for sure.
Yeah.
I would take a whole cup of that for sure. Yeah. Okay, next up we're gonna move over to the sundae.
That looks like a paw, like an animal paw.
Right in the center there?
Yeah. Should we try the first bite virgin?
Okay, cool.
It's very squishy. Oops. Done!
Cheers. Wow.
It's the most moist sundae I've ever had.
It's so moist.
If it was any more wet, it'd be like porridge.
It is almost like porridge stuck together, yeah. And then it has this fragrance, almost like an herbaceous fragrance to it.
As if there's like a very teeny amount of gyeonyip.
Oh man.
But I know what you mean, there's like some aroma.
There's an aftertaste that's kind of herbal. That's the best sundae I've ever had.
The next bite, we shall dip into the soy sauce with scallion.
With that sauce, a subtle saltiness.
It tastes good by itself too.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need the sauce.
You're right. Once you start eating that, you'll eat the entire spoke.
The wheel of sundae.
All right, Pyongyang Naengmyeon. We haven't forgotten about you.
Let's cut it.
Okay.
You want to do the honors?
Sure. How many times? Just once?
However much your heart says. Two is fine.
One cut that way?
Yeah.
One cut this way?
Yeah.
Because they really wrap the noodles into a bundle, yeah?
So now the noodles are very short. Hope you don't mind.
They slide out of your chopsticks so easily.
I was a bad teacher. You just need to cut it once.
Once's would be good.
Same noodles. This is more of the traditional kind. Native Koreans, older generation I talk with, they say the authentic Pyongyang Naengmyeon, the noodles are not so chewy, and the broth is more mild. It might be a good thing it's raining today because she was saying on warmer days there's a line outside, but it is raining right now.
Let's try the broth. No, not yet.
That could also be a drink.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Amazing how it's light and refreshing but kind of meaty at the end of your bite.
time to try the 소고기 초무침, which contains beef, cucumber, pepper, and carrot.
How does it make you feel?
Refreshing but meaty, and then sweet and sour.
Mm-hmm. And the meat is a little bit more on the breaded side. It's a little bit more friction in there. The cucumber is very crunchy, so they balance each other out.
Mm-hmm. Snappy crunch to it.
Snappy.
Yep.
The snappy this is.
You can probably hear it on your teeth. You can feel it on your teeth, that same snap.
So this in Korean is 소고기, and this is chewier than the noodles. I was talking to the woman who works here, and she was saying that here the noodle is not as chewy because there's more buckwheat, and because it's not chewy, it's easier to digest.
Wow, that place is getting packed.
Yeah.
What was your favorite thing you had here?
I like the beef with the cucumber.
Mm. Yeah, that's it.
Alright, up next we are going to Hadan. We are on a time crunch. It's 12:20 and it's gonna take about 40 minutes to get there by the taxi. So we'll be there at 1-ish and then the restaurant closes at 2 and then they reopen at 5.
Woohoo! We made it to Hadan. The dark exterior makes a beautiful contrast with the rain.
Yeah, you're right. The bricks used to be red, but it looks like they painted over it. So this place, I actually had an Airbnb here about 2-3 years ago. Thankfully there's no queue. Thank you, Mother Nature, for raining.
Good to go.
In my experience being in Korea, whenever you take off your shoes at the entrance and leave them at the door, that's already your first number one sign that it's going to be a good restaurant. Maybe it's the way you feel and your comfort as well.
Yeah.
But that translates to good food, usually.
Because when you go into Asian household, the traditional Asian house, like in Korea too, you take off your shoe and you put your guard down and then boom, the food just like attacks you.
It's so and immediately, the comfort just overwhelms you.
Our options include mandukguk, mandu jeonggol, jinmandu, nokdu jijim, and maemil naengkalguksu.
Wow, look at how amazing that looks.
Wow.
That is what we shall get. It's kind of creepy though. It's like too many legs, but it also looks cool. You guys, we just found out that they don't serve this one, the jeonggol, on the weekend because it gets busy.
It's just too long of a dish.
So for mandu jeonggol, come on the weekday. Can you sense the sadness on our face?
Yeah, it's devastating. Yeah. But that's okay, we'll have lots of other things.
That's okay, we'll bring our own mushrooms and put in the soup. Mandukguk, they have mandu soup.
Mandu soup,
and they have a market down the street, so I could bring the enoki mushroom. Basically, they do have pindaetteok here, but they call it something else. They call it nokdu jijim. And the pindaetteok contains nokdu, and nokdu is mung bean. So when you come here, you have to order minimum 2 servings of the noodles, but everything else you can get 1 serving.
It's almost 2 p.m.
Wow, that pindaetteok smell.
Oh yeah, that smell is coming from the
pindaetteok.
Mandukguk, dumpling soup for 9,000 won, about $7.50 US. You can also order dumplings without the soup. Radish kimchi as a side. The noodles here are 3 to 4 times thicker than the ones we had at Dongmu Papsang. Mmm, so many sesame seeds. Ah, just admire how they have settled onto the strands. Thinly sliced radish and cucumber strips coexist with the noodles.
And I want to confirm, yes, it is buckwheat. It says naengmyeon here. And it's kalguksu. Totally, and kalguksu is a knife-cut noodle.
Knife-cut, so these aren't even, the name of this dish is not even the naengmyeon.
Yes,
naengmyeon. It's a totally different name too. This is cold so it can wait, but we gotta eat that mung bean pancake fast, just kind of break it apart.
Oh yeah. Done.
Just that golden crispy edge, okay.
Perfect for a rainy day like this.
So warm and cozy in your mouth, and crispy.
The edge is like uber crispy.
Yeah, and then you taste the inside, because it's mung bean, it's not flour. It's kind of beany.
Mung beany,
so good.
Fact.
It's so good.
How does the nokdu jijim taste with the dipping sauce?
That brings out the flavor. Oh wow. It's salty and sour, the sauce. Cooling off very rapidly.
Let's rehydrate.
Let's rehydrate. Reduce it.
Rejuvenate it. they put some pepper on
it. And there's something in here too, like a...
I think that's beef.
Looks like beef, maybe a beef broth.
It tastes homemade. It tastes pretty clean.
Mm. And also, I do like that the wrapper is quite thin as well.
You know, I personally like it thin so that you can really feel the filling.
Yep, exactly.
Dumplings contain pork. He was saying that if we use beef, it's going to be not as soft.
Ah, okay.
The broth is made with hogi.
You can taste a little beef in that broth. But again, very light.
Deep meat flavor right there. That's good.
Okay, we have also a plate of just the dumplings without the soup as well.
Well, they were once moist, but now they have steam evaporated.
For this one, I will dunk it in the sauce.
It has cooled down a lot.
Cheers.
Cheers. Chang. Mm-hmm. You know what I noticed? When you eat, you take the whole thing, and I would do half.
One bite, it's actually like a solid meatball in there.
There's scallion, some chili flake.
Oh, a lot of scallion, yeah.
It is on the mild side, but I like it like that.
Because then the sauce like really brings out the flavor.
Yes, mix it all up.
And you can smell those sesame seeds as you brought them over.
Those noodles are amazing.
Again, they're not that chewy.
It's a nice, smooth texture.
It's a good, mm-hmm. a really good texture. What makes it for me is those sesame seeds.
You get little, cute little pops mm-hmm. whenever you bite into the sesame seeds. Mm. It's on the sweet side.
But it tastes kind of like a pear sweet, or like a fruity sweet.
Like a diluted fruit candy.
Yeah, it's almost like apple juice.
It is 2:20. We are the last people here. Whoa, that kimchi is so spicy. It's not that spicy to you?
A little bit.
What I'm noticing here, the entrees are on the gentle side, and then the banchan, it's like more loud. They really color things up.
But it definitely is spicier than many other Korean restaurants I've been to.
May I have a radish one over there?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sorry.
No worries. Not nearly as spicy. I'm just kidding, it's spicy. It's kicking in. What is your favorite thing you had on this table?
I like noodle.
This one, come here. I like noodle. How about you, Mark?
I think possibly the mandu and the soup, but also the noodles are spectacular. Mm. Like, I would be happy to come here and just have this bowl of noodles.
Yeah. My personal favorite was the dumpling and dokdujijim. 안녕히 계세요. 우산 하나 있어요. She's asking if you want umbrella. Oh, she said she's gonna give us umbrella.
She's really cool. She's so friendly in the end that she actually put my backpack on for me.
Yeah, I saw that.
She wouldn't let me go out with putting my backpack on, and then she offered an umbrella coming out here.
Yeah, when we first got there, the gentleman working there, he was like happy grumpy. He was saying grumpy things with a smile. But they really warmed up to us. And they were friendly and telling us about the history. The lady who works here, her parents moved here from North Korea when they were fleeing during the Yu-Gi-Oh! For round three, we're heading to Gangnam, which is south from here, 30 minutes by taxi. We're gonna go to Jinni Pyongyang Naengmyeon. Watch out for the puddles. It's kind of rugged here. It's 3:34.
We made it to Jinmi Pyongyang Naengmyeon, which is featured in the 2019 Michelin Guide.
Ah, 면수예요?
예, 예. 냉면 3만원이래요.
The noodles that the water was cooked in, it's that. So the flavor reminds me a lot of noodle-ji.
여기 세 개요.
큰 거.
Big size.
다 드실 수 있나요? 예. 중자는 2인에서 3인양이고요. 얘는 거의 5인양인데 괜찮을까요? 얘 하나, 밭.
아, 예, 네.
Our side dishes include strips of radish and napa cabbage kimchi. Our portable stove makes its entrance.
Look at the excitement in Mark's face.
I'm so hungry for this dish. The big size dish that we just ordered. I can't wait.
You know, when I saw the photo of this dish we ordered, I was like, whoa, exciting. But then when I saw his face, I'm like, wow, I'm super excited now.
I've been waiting for this moment.
Wow, check out the obok jengban. This boiled meat platter looks like a forest.
Enoki mushroom, hard-boiled egg, gennip. All right, this is a jeokban.
We ordered a half serving of bosam, pork that is often boiled and other times steamed.
Naengmyeon. Oh, and the noodles are totally different looking as well.
The pan height is so short compared to the amount of food on it. As the waitress turns the ingredients over, we drool and drool and drool some more. An empty space is caved in on the top to bring back the sauce bowl.
Gotta love when it first came out, it was like opening up like a flower.
What she just poured in is naengmyeon soup, meat broth.
I think the concept for today is getting to the edge, because look at this soup.
That's an infinity edge.
Infinity edge.
The yuksu boils, heating up the metal sauce pan. This boiled meat platter looks extra cozy because it's a rainy day.
Let's get some meat, a little bit of everything. Oh, how about enoki mushroom?
Oh, thank you.
Oh, they spill off so easily.
Everything is so soft and boiled to perfection.
The leek leaked out of Mark's mouth. Can you tell I like puns?
If you just have only the meat, it kind of tastes a little lonely. It's tasty, but lonely. But if you pair it with all the leek, and then with the chrysanthemum leek.
And again, just like the rest of the dishes that we've had today, it's not like overpowering in flavor. Mm-hmm. But it just like is somehow addictive though.
It tastes really natural. It tastes homey. And it tastes so comforting. It's like a healthy soul food. Because yeah, comfort food that can be like
yeah, it's almost herbal. Almost like herbal broth.
Shall we try some kimchi?
Yeah.
There's some fermentation in that for sure.
I love the sourness, mm-hmm. Yeah. Sometimes when the kimchi is really nicely aged, it almost like zings your tongue a little bit.
Yeah.
Like it's almost like fizz. Do you normally wrap it though or?
So if they gave us leaves, you can put it in leaves, but here we'll just eat it by
what
itself.
What is it called?
So this is bosam. It's a steamed pork.
Oh, it's tender.
Layers of texture. Mm-hmm. I was asking what kind of sauce that is, They just said it's a sauce. They didn't say what's inside.
That's soft. We're not gonna cut it this time. Wow, that is a blob of noodles.
Maybe it's not that chewy because it's breaking apart.
It is breaking apart,
easily.
Yeah.
These noodles are so tangled that they remind me of long hair that flipped and flopped in the wind during a car ride with all the windows rolled down.
I lost like my whole blob of noodles. Yeah, they're not really chewy at all. It's full of noodles, very light.
The other ones have more complexity. This one's more simple.
Very simple, yet soothing and comforting. They taste like wheat to me.
Oh, she said it's 80% buckwheat.
Oh, again, the flavor is so light on this bowl of noodles. But like at the same time, you can't stop eating it. And the other thing is the broth is not sweet at all.
Just a little bit. At first, when we saw this dish, we were like, oh, we could totally finish that because it looks thin enough. But dude, it is dense, layers upon layers upon layers, and no matter how much we eat, it just does not disappear.
It just keeps regrowing.
It's a bottomless pit. So, I'm gonna go on my tippy toe because Mark is
on. Okay, I'll come down, I'll lean down.
What did you enjoy the most today of all the three restaurants we went to?
I think like the range of dishes at the first restaurant. We ate a lot of noodles, but that place, okay, they had noodles too, but it was totally different from
anything
that I've
seen. So many different colors, and then also the sundae.
That was one of the best dishes of the day for sure.
So moist. For me.
So gooey.
So gooey. What looked the most interesting to you guys? Let us know in the comments section. And Mark, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
For writing your email to me yesterday and like
no
we made
problem.
It happen.
No, I'm glad you were still here.
Wow.
And glad we could meet up and hang out and eat.
Amazing. So for Mark,
sure. Thank
hope
you.
To reunite with you again.
Yeah, for sure.
In
for
either
sure.
Korea or Thailand, wherever.
Let's make it happen.
Yeah. And with Ying too.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. And check out Mark's channel. I'll put
thank
the links
you.
To his channels in the description box. If you guys watch his videos, you're gonna stop watching me.
No way. Your videos are awesome and your
nice.
Creativity of food and your personality is awesome.
Thank you. Thank you, Mark. Thank
you're
you.
You're awesome.
See you.
Thank you.
See you sooner than later.
Yeah.
Hi, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for eating with us and being our camerawoman for both of us. Amazing.
Thank you.
Bright smile too, beautiful.
Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. For food and travel around the world, check out my other channel, Miss Mina. To relax at night, listen to ASMR Bedtime with Miss Mina. We read, crunch, crinkle, and more. In the sunset's gold. 안녕, 친구.
I'm sorry, I'm trying not to cut your face, but my arm is not long.
You stand under the umbrella. It's raining. It's raining today, too.
It's raining, yeah. Okay, this whole week, it's been warm, and the past few days felt like summer, but you guys brought the rain from Bangkok. Thank you, because I personally love rain.
I don't know if you're supposed to start with the outside exterior or the inside.
You know, they say if you start with the interior, you're more of like a blood type AB eccentric.
Oh, okay.
Just kidding, really? I'm making that up. We're on a time crunch. We have 15 minutes because we gotta go to the next restaurant that is only open today from 12 to 2 and then the break time and then for dinner open again.
So we gotta eat fast and move. But we have a few more dishes to try.
Oh, naengmyeon!
You wanna try the naengmyeon?
Let's do it. You guys, look at... look at... That's good. Look at Mark's mic. It looks like an alpaca. And this is a road mic.
I like to call it, it's got dreadlocks. It's been weathered, it has dreadlocks now.
And this is a road mic, right?
This is the Shure.
Oh! Shure. Okay, so because you call it roadkill, and I think this is a road mic.
Pun?
This is a pun.
But you gotta show how bright and beautiful and puffy yours is.
Okay, mine looks like this. I'm gonna unscrew it.
Yeah. Look at that fluffiness.
So yours used to be like this.
Yeah, you did, used
That's
to be.
So fun. We only hung out for a couple hours, but I already know when Mark gets hungry. He starts getting kind of like, he's like looking at people's food.
It smells really good over there.
You know what the thing is, the distance from the first place to here.
It's been like an hour since the last meal.
Yeah.
It's been a while.
Yeah. So this guy ate plenty, but already digested.
Oh, amazing. Round two.
Actually, that drive was a good intermission digesting period. Are you hungry as well?
No. But I can eat.
Choose my legs.
Right here. Arch.
Set it here. I'll just get closer.
I can't break off. Oh. Wait, one more time.
Do you like the art I'm making here? Painting the table.
This is a bite I just have to have. I gotta get this to my mouth fast. This is a one-biter.
Yes! I love that face. At first, I was a little concerned it might be a bit cold near the entrance door because it's completely open constantly. But you know, I'm so glad we're sitting here because I'm getting hot. How about you? We're getting steamed
so
over
warming.
Here. Yeah.
Like a hole in the ceiling on a rainy day, drops fall from the plate, creating a puddle on the portable stove.
Oh yeah.